echoes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to that you are the reason.
There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason my heart keeps bleeding. I need to know, if I could turn back the clock, make sure the light feeds every hour of every day, keeping you safe.
Dear friends,
we are gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman, Albert and Marianne, in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying to us the mystical union that exists between Christ and His Church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beatified with His presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons now come to be joined. I'm reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. And if I should have prophecy and should know all my mysteries and all knowledge, and if I should have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. And if I should distribute all my goods to feed the poor, and if I should deliver my body to be burned and have not charity, it profiteth me nothing. Charity, patience, is kind. Charity envies not. It deals not perversely. It's not puffed up. It is not ambitious. It seeks not her own. It's not provoked to anger, thinking no evil. Rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Charity never fails. Whether prophecies shall be made void, or tongues shall cease, or knowledge shall be destroyed. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that is which is perfect is come, that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away the things of a child. We see him now through a glass in a dark manner. Albert and Marianne, you have this day taken this step to cement your relationship into a more perfect union. It is indeed a wonderful and exciting time for the two of you, your families, and even your friends. In taking this step, you have brought to fulfillment your dreams from when you first met and courtship began. I only want to remind you both that today you begin a new dream together, that of building your own family and growing old together. I might add also that the road ahead will include some rough stretches. But when you come to those sections of your journey together, just remember all the traits, all the things that attracted you to the other. I assure you, it will cover up for a whole lot of things. So I charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy home. If the solemn vows you are about to make are kept faithfully, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of God, your life will be full of joy, and the home you are establishing will abide in peace. No other ties are more tender, no other vows more sacred than those you now assume. Now, Albert, repeat after me. I'll respond when I ask you to. Albert, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only to her so long as you both shall live? If you will, say, I will.
I will.
Marianne, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only to him so long as you both shall live? What are the rings? I assume the bigger one is Albert. Okay. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and woman in holy matrimony. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Albert, take the ring for Marianne and repeat after me. In token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may put it on her finger. Marianne, this will be yours to put on his finger later. Repeat after me. In token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. For as much as Albert and Marianne have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. Let's pray. O eternal God, creator and preserver of us all, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon Albert and Marianne, whom we bless in your name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your laws. Look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, and cherish each other, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a heaven of peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now you may face the people. I'm proud to present to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Albert Acosta. Let's hear. I'll tell you. Now you can face one another. Now you may kiss the bride.
Give me a run for my money. There is nobody, no one to outrun me. So give me a run for my money. Sipping bubbly, feeling lovely, living lovely. Just love.
Blade on curve, will you still
love me?
If I made up my mind at work, will you still
love me?
Keep it 100, I'd rather you trust me than you
love me.
Keep it a whole 100, don't grab you, I got nothing.
I got something. We gon' function, no assumptions. Feeling like fighting with it, knock it out twice, I'm with it.
If I didn't ride blade on curve, will you still
love me?
If I made up my mind at work, will you still
love me?
Keep it a 100, I'd rather you trust me than you
love me.
Keep it a whole 100, don't let you, I got nothing.
Give me a run for my money. There is nobody, no one to outrun me. Give me a run for my money. Feeling lovely.
From this moment, I have been